आवाज आ रही है सर? एम आई ऑडिबल? ऑडिबल? आई एम ऑडिबल? So hello everyone, am I audible to everybody? Dr. Arun?
Yeah, you're audible, Dr. Yashika.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. First of all, I would like to thank to the Aurangabad and Latur study group for giving me an opportunity to present session on Vipra and helping me out to provide my whatever knowledge I have to the participants. And I can see there are so many participants who have already joined. I'm thankful to everybody. So without wasting any more time, if somebody wants, if you want to contribute, ma'am, if you want to say something, please proceed, or shall I start with the session? Shall I start with the session?
You can start.
Okay, sir. Sure.
Yes.
So here we are. I'm going to teach you. I'm Dr. Yashika Arora from DKMM Homeopathic Medical College, Aurangabad. I am going to teach you Vipra from Ophidia group. So let's begin with the session. First of all, I would like to introduce you to the Ophidia group. As we are studying since many days, Ophidia group, and I am sure everybody must be knowing many things about it. So I'll just brief about some of the points about Ophidia group, and then we'll begin with the Vipra. So first of all, I've written a very good quote, which I've read when I was reading for Ophidia group. That is, la envidia di la serpente. That means envy kills of serpents. Envy kills of serpents means ki the jealousy, the envy, the enviness, the jealousy inside the serpents kills off them. So that is the negative point of the serpents, the snakes, the Ophidia group. So let's start. No creature has taken a place so mysterious as snakes. They are the resemblance of deity and evil at the same time. They are connected to deceit, that is wrong things, false things, dishonesty. They are not honest. They are proud people, but at the same time, they are timid, shy to the trespasser in their territory. Whoever passes, they are almost shy to such people in their territory, those who come to their territory. Their movement is majestic. Snakes are majestic. Their appearance are biased by fear. People fear them. So they have a reservation in those that search for them. Throughout the history, it has been continuous.
বাবা Your audio is muted.
Am I audible now? Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir, please share the screen.
Your audio is coming.
So shift the... Dr. Arun, can you please share the...
Hello.
Am I audible? I think Dr. Arun, please close off your please close off your screen, or otherwise start the presentation. I think there is some miscommunication.
Hello. ओके तो तुम बोलते जाओ, या सेकंड ऑप्शन है मोबाइल पे झूमो है क्या? ठीक, मेरा खाली माइक बंद रहेगा। हाँ हेलो। ओके
So please start the video or the presentation.
Okay.
Please begin the presentation. Share the presentation screen. Thank you. share the screen, please. Yeah, the fifth slide, I think, Dr. Farrington. Yeah, this one. So let's see what Dr. Farrington has mentioned about Dr. Ophidia. I already told that Dr. Farrington has mentioned about Ophidians that they affect the throat. They cause constriction, dryness, difficult deglutition, hoarseness. Then the next thing which he has told is the anxiety and the apprehensiveness. These are two main symptoms which you should remember while reading Ophidians. That is anxiety and apprehensiveness, which is being seen precordial in, I think, Lachesis, Crotalus, and Naja. These three medicines Dr. Farrington has mentioned for anxiety as well as apprehensiveness. Then he has also mentioned that all these snake remedies have an ecstasy. They have some moral confusion. They have vivid imaginations. They are loquacious, talk so much, moves from one topic to another. They are suspicious people. They have a sort of jealousy, forgetfulness, envy, pride, sadness, mixed with anxiety. And the main feature which everybody would have learned in Lachesis as well in the previous sessions, that they must loosen their clothes as tight clothing makes them worse. The tight clothing they cannot wear. Ophidians cannot wear light clothing. Next slide, please, Dr. Arun. Thank you. Then I would like to tell you about the diathesis of Ophidians, that is hemorrhagic diathesis they have. They have a melancholic temperament. Hemorrhagic diathesis, one can understand that snakes, whenever snake bites or whatever, whenever snake bites, there is a bleeding tendency. So that can be related to the hemorrhagic diathesis. The miasm they have is the virulent acute miasms, like scarlatina, yellow fever, meningitis, diphtheria, typhoid. When these remedies are in the chronic sphere, they reflect degeneration, senility, old age, idiocy, confusion, apoplexy. There may be drunkenness when you talk about chronic sphere of Ophidians. Next slide, please, sir. Then the discharges of Ophidians are offensive, profuse, bloody, dark. You can consider it as offensiveness. You must remember as profuse. You must remember as bloody. You must remember as dark. These are four characteristics of their discharges. And there is a periodicity which is being seen in maximum Ophidians. Plus, this sphere of action is mainly on the nerves, especially pneumogastric nerves, spinal accessory nerves, livers, glands, skin, circulation, throats, and muscles. So, next slide, please. I would like to describe some of the mentals of the Ophidians that are the main mentals. That is mental excitement, anxiety, hallucinations, loquacity, fear of being poisoned, of disease, death. There is a clairvoyance. They can depict what is going to happen soon. They have a religious insanity. You must have seen Lachesis. They are religious. They are insane. They are fastidious, active, greedy. That's the animal group feature. Fastidious, they have a quarrelsome behavior, competitiveness. They are attractive, plus they have double standards. They have two sets of rules for them. One is for themselves, and the other is for the other people because of their ego and jealousy. So they are double standard. You can find many of maximum Ophidians, the patients requiring Ophidia, Ophidia group remedy will be having double standards. They saw some of the clinical conditions which we have already discussed. They must be seen in hemorrhagic tendency diseases like hemorrhage, hemorrhoids, gangrene, endocarditis, angina, boils, carbuncles, cardiac asthma, varicose veins. What the remedy we'll be continuing today will be for that is a, one of the best remedy which I have seen in my practice for varicose veins, that is Vipra. Next slide, please. So these are the few snake remedies which are the homeopathic remedies of snake group, that is Lachesis, Naja, Elaps, Crotalus. I've mentioned which of the which all remedies have their source from which. If anybody wants, I can share this presentation with you all people also. We have Crotalus horridus, Crotalus cascavilla, Cenchrus, Bothrops, Vipra. There are five species of Vipra, that is Vipra berus, Cumminus, Vipra jedi, Vipra aspis, Vipra resili. Next slide, please. Next slide, sir. There are some of the rare remedies also, Hydrophis, Toxiphis, Bungarus, Clotho, Ophitoxinum, Vitis, Oxyuranus, Python, Regia. Today we will be discussing Vipra. So first, let's begin with Vipra. Next slide, please, sir. Yeah, please wait. So Vipra Venom, I would describe first of all the Vipra Venom, which has been used as a hemostat and as well as in hemophilia during major surgeries to stop hemorrhages, as this Venom, Vipran Venom, contains hemorrhagic, necrotic, coagulant and hemolytic substances inside. So which may lead to extensive necrosis. So please, the last slide, shift to the last slide only. Dr. Arun? Yeah. So which may lead to extensive necrosis, lesions due to intravascular coagulation, fibrinolysis. Please shift to the last slide, sir. Yeah, thank you so much. So what I want to explain is, when there is a condition which is having a bleeding tendency, you have to stop and stop the hemorrhage, or there is necrosis, or there is extensive necrosis, extensive fibrinolysis, or endothelium is being damaged, or whatever it is, then Vipra Venom has the tendency to make to cure the patient, to treat the patient at that moment of time. They also have anti-tumor properties because of the hemotoxins present inside them, which target the circulatory system as well as clotting ability. They prevent people from heart attacks and blood disorders. So what we can remember is they are useful in the extensive necrosis cases, hemorrhage cases, when there is intravascular coagulation, when there is fibrinolysis, and there is damage to the endothelium or necrosis. Next slide, please. So now we'll study the cycle of Vipra. I would like to explain the how the symptoms occur, how the Vipra generate the symptoms, or how you can study a Vipra in a very better way. So there are 5 points to remember to study Vipra. The first point is release. These are some of the segments which I have, which I was growing through Vipra when I was studying from different books, and I have grasped them. So first segment is release segment, that is bleeding tendency, perspiration, urination, vomiting. I'll be telling you in the next slide. The second segment is the prostration segment, that is the weakness. The patient is so weak. So you can relate it how the patient becomes trapped in the cyclical pattern of illness. The first one is release. The second is prostration. The third is stuckness. They become closed up. Then there is swelling, and which leads to inflammation, festering, tenderness and pain. So next we'll see how the cyclic pattern of illness occurs. Next slide, please. So first segment is release segment. The symptoms which occur due to release, like all skin remedies, snakes remedies, Viper also has a tendency towards release, towards bleeding, towards excessive vomiting, towards perspiration and urination. The bleeding, the vomiting, the perspiration, the urination, they relieve the tension, they relieve the congestion inside, they relieve the painful swelling for which the remedy is very well known. We'll study that. Vomiting occurs during times of stress and anxiety. Okay? So when there is stress and anxiety, there is an injury or there is some suffering that has come from very severe infection and vomiting occurs, like headache is being relieved by vomiting. A very common symptom which we get in practice. So that is what is Vipra. That release is for the betterment of the patient. The perspiration is another mechanism which relieves the congestion. Headache ameliorated by urination, which is a keynote of Vipra as well as Ignatia as well as Chalcemium. You can also see this release segment in the mental state. So during fever and excitement, he may be delirious. A patient may be delirious. He'll become discontented, wanting to move from here and there, and yells at everyone or anyone to do something to help him out. So this can also be related to Belladonna lachesis with this release segment. But the Vipra patient is not as active in the mental sphere, in the emotional sphere. Vipra will be more active release that would be in the physical sphere. Next slide, please. Then due to this release segment, due to so much release, due to bleeding, due to excessive vomiting, due to discharges. Next slide, please. There is a prominent weakness which is being seen after this great loss of blood. Heart may beat weakly, pulse may become thin, he may be bluish, mottled, cold to touch extremities hoti hai, varicosities dekhi jati hai, because of the blood is not circulating properly. This all is the prostration segment. When you talk about a chronic Vipra patient, he'll feel generalized deep tenderness. And there is tiredness and there is intense weakness. They just want to go home and lie down, get their feet up to counter the tired and dragging sensation. This is very much similar to CPR. If you see, if you have read CPR, this is a most common remedy which is being confused with Vipra, because the weakness of CPR and the Vipra can be very much related. But then you must remember the weakness of CPR causes them to become chilly. They are chilly patient and they like warmth in any situation. But when you talk about Vipra, they are hot patients and they like warmth, they like cold in any situation. If you talk about the mental sphere, then this weakness segment can be seen in Vipra as hopelessness, like she may die from her infection. But again, you should not confuse it with lachesis. Because Vipra lacks the intense hysteria of lachesis. Vipra won't be that much hysterical as lachesis. There may be slowness, weakness in the ability to concentrate, focus. They may also stop caring about people or any aspect of the world, like in CPR. Again, a confusing thing with CPR when these two remedies are very much related. But the Vipra will surpass CPR. Matlab, that will surpass CPR in bringing the brightness back to the patient. Okay, Vipra will try to bring that brightness back to the patient. CPR will be like, I don't want to drink. This is a washerwoman's remedy. They become indifferent, so they become indifferent. Next, we have stuck up, closedness, closed segment. Next slide, please. Dr. Arun, next slide. They have stuckness. They have a closed up segment. When you talk about release, bleeding ho gaya, then you have done the before. Sir, last slide only. So release ho gaya, पर्सन को वॉमिटिंग वगैरह हो गया, प्रोस्ट्रेशन हो गया, वीकनेस आ गया, अब आएगा क्लोज्ड अप सेगमेंट. वैसे तो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट वाइपरा, दे आर वेरी, दे हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू फील टू ओपन, जस्ट लाइक फॉस्फोरस पेशेंट. फॉस्फोरस पेशेंट इज अ ओपन पेशेंट, टॉक्स विद एवरीबडी, लाइक सिमिलरली वाइपरा ऑल्सो डज. बट देन when he suffer from hemorrhagic tendency, this release segment, and then they are like they have prostration, due to this over release and prostration they begin to close up, they develop a desire to close off to protect themselves, like they'll develop tumors, they'll develop lumps, especially in the uterus and the breast. So Viper is a very good remedy when you talk about uterine tumor, breast tumor, or any breast lump. These all things will occur because of the prostration and profuse release. They lead to the swelling, bleeding, because the body will find body wants to find a way of holding on in order to curb this release, to stop that release, to stop that bleeding, to stop that hemorrhagic tendency. The patient of Viper will try to hold on. The body will try to hold on. Like fluid and tension build in legs to the point that the legs can hardly be bent. The symptom they'll show ki fluid or tension itna zyada create ho gaya hai legs ke andar ki they cannot even bend. They may feel tightness in the chest with breathing. Matlab they find it difficult to breathe. They feel somehow exposed, unsafe, in a too hurtful or too exhausting world, because they feel a need to hold up or close off. They want to go home to be protected from being hurt. You must remember, Viper is a patient who wants to go home. Next slide, please. Then after this closed up segment, we have a swelling segment. So swelling occurs due to this closed tendency, closing up tendency, holding on tendency. The body will try to result in terrific swelling involving lymph channels and veins. That is where is the best thing being used of Viper, that is the varicose veins. For example, varicose veins become so swollen, become so pulsating that they feel like they will explode, especially when the limb hangs down. This is a common symptom in varicose veins, but then they are those so swollen and so pulsating in Viper that this swelling occurs. There is a terrific swelling. Swelling may also occur in other places, like in a pregnant woman, the face swells up, or the swelling may be internal, even with the feeling of fullness in chest, abdomen, stomach. These are the symptoms which I'm telling you for the Vipra. Like the swelling may occur as in the form of varicose veins, or in the form of hemorrhoids, or in the form of swelling up of face in a pregnant woman, or there may be a feeling of fullness in the chest, abdomen, or stomach. And this is why they hate tight clothing and will remove it, as in maximum obedience you will find. Tight clothing they cannot bear. Humidity and heat will aggravate, which we studied this before also, that Vipra will desire for cold things. They are a hot patient, so humidity and heat will aggravate that. That separates them from sepia as well. So the more she walks in the heat, the more tired and heavy her legs feel. The more it feels like her heart is working overtime. This is a symptom which I have taken from the source book. So the more she walks in the heat, the more tired she'll feel. Next slide, please. So after all this swelling segment and everything, release, prostration, then occurs tucked upness, closeness, swelling. There, this will all result in inflammation. That is the pain segment. That is the tenderness. Swelling in Vipra invariably leads to inflammation of the swollen area. In the form of phlebitis, it can be seen. In the form of deep vein thrombosis, it can be seen. Or any staphylococcal or streptococcal skin infections. Severe gastroenteritis, in which excessive bleeding is there, or in case of amputation as well, in a diabetic patient as well. So the symptom which can be related is when the varicose veins become engorged, they become distended and stagnant, they can inflame upon slightest injury. When the patient suffers from varicose veins, that was in the previous section, the swelling segment, the varicose veins become engorged, they can now inflame. कोई भी छोटी सी इंजरी होगी पेशेंट को, they can inflame the slightest injury. Injury due to bite of animals like snakes, dogs, or injury that are not even healing may respond to this remedy. अगर कोई पेशेंट है जो कि जैसे इंजर्ड हुआ है और उसको varicose veins की हिस्ट्री थी या हिस्ट्री है, so what and the, those injuries are not healing properly since long, you can think of this remedy. The most important keynote is the pain. Pain segment comes here, that is when letting the limb hang down. When the patient will hang down the limb, the lower limbs will be hanging down. The patient may experience so intense pain that they feel like that area will explode, that area will blast from all throbbing and pressure. That this is also being compared to the bike tire that is full and will pop, that will blast. Like, itna bhar gaya hai bike ke tire ki tarah, वो पेन इतना ज्यादा बढ़ गया है कि पेशेंट को लगेगा वो बर्स्ट आउट हो जाएगा, वो एक्सप्लोड हो जाएगा. एंड दिस इज दिस इन्फ्लेमेशन यू कैन आल्सो रिलेट इन द मेंटल सेशन, दैट इज इन हाईली एंग्शियस स्टेट, दैट इज अ कॉमन सिम्टम फॉर ऑल ऑफिडियंस. अ वेरी हाईली एंग्शियस स्टेट कैन बी द सिम्टम ऑफ वाइप्रा. द पेशेंट टॉसेस अबाउट, टर्न्स, स्क्रीम्स फ्रॉम पेन, कैनॉट बी काम डाउन, ही वोंट स्टॉप, ही वोंट काम डाउन. Fever may also accompany the state. And if that pain is so severe, the patient may become delirious like in Belladonna, which where you can get confused with Belladonna. But do remember one thing, that Belladonna's delirium is much more active with lots of thrashing and excitement. Belladonna is an extreme level. The Viagra patient will show more confusion. Viagra and Belladonna patient may have fever delirium, but you must differentiate between Belladonna and Viagra, that Belladonna is so much active that there is lot of excitement, but when you come to Viagra, they'll more show you confusion. Then next slide, sir. So about Viagra. This is an venomous old world snake characterized by hollow venom conducting fangs in the upper jaw. They have fangs in the upper jaw. You can identify this species as similar to this. It is prepared, the medicine is prepared from fresh venom of a poisonous snake called common European adder or the common European viper from Viperidae family. It's a small poisonous terrestrial viper found all over the region extending from northwestern Europe or to the far off Asia, Far East Asia, Eastern and Southeastern Asia. Next slide, please. But you can you must know this, that Viagra is not considered as a very treacherous reptile. It is not at all considered being very harmful because it survives on small mammals, amphibians, birds, lizards, and sometimes even on worms, insects, and spiders. Viagra snake is not even so much aggressive. They only bite when they are disturbed or being startled. जब आप उसे उन्हें provoke करेंगे तभी वो bite करते हैं. And their bite even are extremely excruciating, but rarely fatal. So they may be painful. The bite may be extremely painful, but they won't be fatal. They won't be dangerous to the life. The bite may result in swelling, intense pain. Just remember the doctrine of signature. The bite of the viper results in swelling, intense pain, hemorrhage of blood vessels, vein enlargement. So just remember that it can extensively be prescribed to heal such conditions when you have swelling, intense pain, hemorrhage of blood vessels or vein enlargement, as well as any of the associated symptoms. Next slide. We'll study the common clinical conditions in which Viagra can be useful. That is epistaxis, goiter, hemorrhages, jaundice, enlargement of liver, neurasthenia, phlebitis, premature senility, swelling of tongue, varicose veins, leg cramps, paralysis of lower limbs, poliomyelitis, menopausal problems, lymphangioma, boils and carbuncles. These are few of the conditions which our source books have stated that Vipera can be useful in such conditions. Next slide. There are a few more conditions. Next slide. Like the utility of Vipera can be seen in the form of when the patient is suffering from great anxiety, premonition of death. The patient may be having fear of thunderstorm, traveling by car, divine punishment, and death. Overstimulation cases, maybe you can use it, that one needs a valve or an outlet. When he's so closed up, there is so much stimulation in the body that one needs to finish off that stimulation. For the cases of adultery with high sexuality, Vipera can be used. The mentors of Vipera is extreme jealousy, which may lead to asthma, or there may be suspicion, which may lead to purplish bluish discoloration over the body, like in varicose veins. Sensitivity to touch, palpitation may be there. The Vipera patient have a guilt projection. They have guilt projecting. So we can use them for paraplegia of lower extremities as discussed before, resembling a very clinical condition we study, that is ascending paralysis of Landry. The Vipera patient can be used in cases which have cardiac anguish with violent and chest pains. Next slide, please. So just remember, any individual who is suffering from an ailment that has certain symptoms of this sickness. For example, somebody having varicose veins that are tender and enlarged. So this can be useful homeopathic treatment based on the theory. Like we'll find out the symptoms, we'll be searching for the similimum remedy. When anything goes inside a human being causes certain physical effects. Use of the same substance taken in minute and diluted amounts. This is what is our theory that helps the body in healing the problem or the health condition. Therefore, just remember one thing. When an individual is bitten by a viper, it results in the swelling and tenderness of the veins. Keeping in view the theory behind homeopathic remedies, like we have a law of similia is based on similia similibus curantur, that taking the venom of the same snake, that is viper, in diluted form will obviously facilitate stimulating the body to treat varicose veins. Just remember why viper is being used. The doctrine of signature is the viper is being used for varicose veins because of their source, that is when an individual is bitten by the viper, it results in the swelling and tenderness of the veins. That is the major symptom. The next slide, please. So just remember, this remedy is useful in treating excruciating swelling of veins, as in the case of varicose veins, plus hemorrhages, epistaxis, bursting feeling, especially in varicose veins and elevating parts, sits with feet high. So I think I should stop right now, and we'll continue the Vipera tomorrow after this. So if anybody has any doubt regarding what we have studied up till now, please ask in the chat box. So I'll clear the doubts. Sir, please stop the presentation. Yeah. Or you can even mail me at dryashikaarora@gmail.com. Sir, please stop the presentation. We'll study tomorrow. We'll proceed tomorrow. Anybody who wants to ask any query, so you can ask. If anybody was unable to hear anything or had some issue, I'm typing my contact number in the chat box, you can ask your query, plus my email ID, where you can mail me even for your query. You can also WhatsApp me or mail me for the presentation. I think somebody has asked, Dr. Tanushka Verma has asked you for the presentation. I'll share the presentation after I complete my session tomorrow. I have session tomorrow again, continuing Vipra as well. We'll be continuing Vipra. There are symptoms at physical level, mental level, which is being left. So I'll explain everything out, and then after tomorrow, I can share the presentation even. Is there any doubt? So you can ask. Somebody is having any doubt, please ask in the chat box or raise your hand if you want to ask any doubt. Tomorrow at 3 p.m. we'll be joining again and continuing this Vipra and the symptoms. I hope everybody will be coming tomorrow again. And then we can also discuss many of the things related to cases which come in your OPD and require Vipra or Ophidia group remedies. Please, I request everybody, whoever is sharing their email IDs, can you please mail me separately? I've already mentioned my mail in the chat box, dryashikaarora@gmail.com, because that would be convenient for me. If you mail, I'll revert back to you. Dr. Rajesh Roshan, I think, and Dr. Richa Bajpai, whoever is asking for the presentation. Any doubts, any queries somebody wants to ask? You can type in the chat box any queries. There are two participants who have raised hand. I think Dr. Sheikh Aisha wants to ask something. Dr. Sheikh Aisha, I think you are, I've given you the permission. You can ask your query. Or you can chat with me. You can reply whatever query you have. Anybody is having any queries? So we'll end up this session for today and we'll continue tomorrow. Dr. Arun? Yeah, we'll try to improve the audio and video quality. I think there was some miscommunication and some technical issues because of which we could not share. Dr. Arun? Am I audible to you? Dr. Arun? I have unmuted you.
Yes, audible.
Yes. So we'll end up this session. You want to say something or you want to continue?
I think the senior most person is there in the group, Dr. Yogesh Neturkar sir,
yeah,
who is a lecturer at Latur College.
Yeah.
I request Yogesh sir to say something. Please unmute him.
I'm not finding him in the...
Yogesh sir?
I'll just search. हाँ, I've unmuted him.
योगेश सर, प्लीज रेज
I've unmuted him. So please.
Thank you, Dr. Arun. Yeah.
Welcome, sir. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity.
It is my pleasure to. You had covered a majority part up till now in the first part in terms of the various references that you had given that adds the overall understanding of the Opidia group. Then in terms of the sphere of action, its clinical indications, then the mental aspect of Opidia group, and overall the rare remedies that you had shared is the best of the things, because most of the participants or most of us are aware about only of the we revolve around only 2-3 remedies of Opidia group, but you had covered the rare part also, so that is also one of the good thing that all of us have learned about the rare remedies. And the overall description of Vipera was also most of the things were part of the learning session, and it was an overall good session that we had learned, and we are now looking forward for tomorrow's session in whatever remaining portion you are going to cover, apart from the technical difficulties we had encountered, but somehow we have tackled in terms of sharing Dr. Arun's screen. And I think Vipera is one of the best remedy that can be indicated in various disease conditions, especially that are related to the blood vessels. You had shown various images also in what way the pathology can represent. The pictorial representation was also very good. Vast details are there. Only thing is that if possible, you can conceptualize it in as what we can say in Bogar. You can cover it that part too, so that the learners or the students can remember the essence of that remedy. In one or two slides, it can be covered. Okay.
Sure, sir. Sure.
I'm just adding a suggestion to that, so that we can remember it in a proper way, and the image will be imprinted in our mind. Okay.
Sure, sir. Overall, sure, I will.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Thank you everybody for your patience and being with me, and thank you so much.